Welcome to episode 9, Monitoring and Analytics, Tracking Your SERP Success. How do you know where you're going if you don't know where you're coming from? Without monitoring and tracking, it's very difficult to measure the outcome of your investment into SEO, whether it's time, whether it's your teams, whether it's money, it's definitely energy. Make sure you're monitoring all of the right key performance indicators and then adjusting in real time as is necessary to get to the top of the SERP results. In this episode, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. Are you enjoying these videos? If you are, I'd really appreciate you subscribing to the channel to stay engaged, and I'll catch you in the next video. So guys, not monitoring and tracking your site's performance effectively is a little bit like attempting to drive from London to Glasgow just using the old physical AA maps that we have or had here in the UK. It's going to be potentially outdated. You're not going to know if any of the roads have changed. You're not going to know if there's any diversions. You need to use a little bit of intuition and guesswork, or a lot of intuition and guesswork, to determine the correct route, the correct time it will take, and therefore it has so many ongoing implications for your journey and everything else around it. Whereas that problem, of course, goes away when you introduce Google Maps and Apple Maps. So we're going to be showing you all of the things that you need to do to ensure you can get and measure exactly what it's going to take to get to your destination. Let's get into it. So today, everybody, we're going to give you the three box strategy. We'll be doing the Google Toolbox, the Semrush Toolbox, and the good old Brain Box. Let's get into it. Okay, so let's now go through the Google Toolbox, beginning with Bard. So I've used Bard to tell me the rest of the Google Toolbox. The more that you're able to lean into using tools such as Bard, ChatGPT, or otherwise, the quicker you're going to get the answers that you're looking for. And in this instance, the answers, of course, are, what is the Google Toolbox? So this is a really good precis of what to think about when it comes to the way to track and monitor SEO results. And in this instance, without any links, is hyperlinks. So we'll just go ahead and open this up. So if we go to the Google Search Console, this is a fantastic platform which you can go ahead and get set up to monitor SEO results. So now if I go ahead and look at, for example, Google Search Console once again, we can go ahead and see exactly what is in the Google Toolbox. So if we jump now to here, what you'll see now as we jump in, we can look at Pearl Lemon and you'll get a sense of some of the activity here. So as we can see over time, it has got close to 13,000 clicks. And then there's different ways to track metrics within the actual Google Search Console environment. And equally, you can set up and do the same things with analytics, with Lighthouse, with PageSpeed, with Google Trends, as well as Merchant Center. So Search Console is for organic search that comes via Google. Google Analytics is for traffic that comes to your website. And I'm very sure if we look at analytics, Google, there you go. And we head over to the Google, for example, Analytics Academy. We can just still use this to redirect ourselves. And we'll do, as you'll see, we can redirect ourselves to Google Analytics itself. And you can have a look at some of the data. Everything's set up under a team account, and you'll go ahead and get logged into Google Analytics and GA4. And here, as we can see, there's a whole range of websites that we've got. So then if we continue down this list, Google Lighthouse, let's go ahead and open up Google Lighthouse so you get a sense, because this might be the one that you're slightly less familiar with. It's fundamentally great for improving the performance of your sites, alongside and used in conjunction with Google PageSpeed Insights. Trends is for trend tracking, so if there's a breakout trend. So let's have a look as an example about the growth of, for example, and you can see daily trending searches. So this is what's trending today at the time of recording. These gentlemen are trending. So let's go ahead and have a look at David McCallum just to see David McCallum. And there's probably going to be lots of potential news reports. So let's have a look. One hour ago. So he's unfortunately passed away. So it's a really good sense to see what might be good from a content perspective in conjunction with actually your own analytics report. So there's daily search trends. There's real-time search trends the past 24 hours.
This is for the past day, let's call it, if you will. And then you can look by country, you can explore, and you can search for trends yourself. So let's have a look at the growth of TikTok as a platform, or let's have a look at ChatGPT as a query, since we've already been discussing it, Bard as well. So if we go ahead and load metrics, this uses 25 credits. That's pulled in from keywords everywhere. And it's just a lot of incredible insight here. And then of course, as we continue down this list, we've got the Merchant Center for anyone who's using Google Shopping to run ads. And there you have it. This is the Google Analytics Toolbox, beginning with Bard. So now let's have a look at the actual Semrush Toolbox itself. So as you can see, the great thing is that when you plug a site into a site audit, you can set up position tracking, on-page SEO checker, social media trend tracking, you can schedule posts, you can look at backlinks, you could look at link building, PPC keywords, organic traffic. And what I would say, again, if we turn to Bard, and the reason that right now we're using Bard is because it contains up-to-date data. ChatGPT has updated to, I think, around 2021, which means that Bard right now, and of course that's likely to change over time, has the most up-to-date data. So again, another trick to combine the Google search tool with, or rather the Google actual toolbox with the Semrush toolbox, is to jump into actual Bard. And as you'll see now, what features of Semrush are great for monitoring and tracking SEO results include stuff that will reveal not well-known but very useful information. Now I've not asked it to exclude links, and as you can see, there's a whole series of sections that you can look at, and you can click right through. If we just open up this link, as you can see, the position tracking tool, you've got some of the visuals here. So combining these two and then taking a look at what you want to track within Semrush, I think, is a fantastic way to do it. And it may well be that you've got, for example, other actual platforms that you already use or your team has access to. Semrush is very, very powerful from a standpoint of looking at different metrics to track. And as you can see, you can run a competitive analysis for and from a tracking perspective. You can look at competitors from a tracking perspective to understand what a competitor's doing. And all around, using a combination of all of these tools within Semrush, position tracking, keyword research, backlink analytics, on-page, SERP analysis, traffic analytics, competitor analysis, alongside Google, you've got a really powerful way to fundamentally track results from Google as well as Semrush. And now we'll go into talking about the brain box.
And now we come to the good old brain box, the third and most important part, arguably, of the triad. So what is the brain box in this context? Really, it's talking to your sales team, talking to your checkouts team, talking to your lead management team, whatever the name of the team is. Richard, how many leads are we getting? What are the quality of the leads? What are the inquiries that are coming in? What are they saying? How did they find us? When we ask them, what is the nature of the search? What did they exactly do? What browser were they on? Were they on mobile? Were they on desktop? Were they on laptop? Asking these types of questions and getting qualitative and anecdotal data from your team, alongside saying, what are our sales numbers like? Have they increased since we started this activity? Have they decreased? Alongside also checking on the different devices that you come across. Guys, what result are you seeing when you search this? What result are you seeing on mobile, on laptop, on iPad, on desktop when you search this? What about your teams in different countries, different locations? So if you engage in the entirety of the brain box, which is the brains within your department, within your teams, you really are going to get a really good sense of what is actually happening from an SEO perspective. Hey guys, we've come to the end of episode 9. And just to recap, we went through the three box strategy, which is the Google Toolbox, the Semrush Toolbox, and the good old brain box. I hope you took some notes, and now it's time for episode 10.